We review a lot of microphones here at TechFox, but rarely do we get into the added accessories that are typically required to get the most out of your audio recording. Well, in the studio today, we have two products. One is a complete microphone kit with five added accessories. The other is a basic budget microphone with no added accessories, albeit a lot cheaper. Let's compare the two and see which one is right for you. The two products we're looking at today are the BCWO USB microphone and the Toner USB microphone kit. At the time of recording, these products retail on Amazon for $16 and $56 respectively, but I've seen that price fluctuate, so you could get it a little bit cheaper depending on when you purchase it. Wait till the end of this review before you make a final decision though, because we have other products we've reviewed that you may want to compare these to. But if you do decide to purchase these or any other products we review, please always consider using our affiliate link to do so. First up, we'll take a look at the BCWO desktop USB microphone. And when you open up the packaging, you will find the microphone and a user manual. That's it. There is an included windscreen which comes attached, and if you look at the base, you will see a button down there that is an on-off switch. It is not a mute button, which is an important distinction that we'll get into more in a minute. It is advertised as an omnidirectional pickup microphone, meaning you can speak into it in any direction and it should pick you up well. However, if you want to orient the microphone more toward the source of audio, you can move the neck because it is very flexible and will hold its shape. It's also incredibly sturdy, it's not going to fall over easily, and it could be noise canceling. The reason I say could is because there's nothing in the packaging or the advertising that makes me think it's a noise canceling microphone, but listening to the audio I've recorded throughout my testing, it almost seems like it does do a decent job of blocking out any background noise. My experience with the microphone was generally very positive. The setup is definitely where this thing shines. If you're new to YouTube or video editing or audio recording in general, you're really going to like this microphone because you plug it in, there's no additional settings, no drivers, you just make sure it's turned on, and you start recording with it. Incredibly simple. It's also highly mobile. It can fold up easily and stuffed into a backpack or a handbag and brought on the go, and you only need to plug it into any available USB port and start recording. That on-off switch that I mentioned should have just been a mute button, because when you press that button, it effectively disconnects the microphone from the computer. It's the same as simply unplugging the USB, which you can already do. A mute button would have been highly more functional, because you can mute the audio without disconnecting the microphone. Because if you press that button, your computer will cease to see the microphone. And in many audio recording programs, it will stop recording. So you may be recording audio, press the button thinking that it's muted if you want to take a phone call or something, press the button again and start talking, and think that you're still recording your voice, but the recording unfortunately has stopped. So a little bit of a mark against it there, but not a deal breaker for most people. I'll get to an audio test in just a moment, but suffice it to say, the audio quality is actually pretty good considering how much you pay for it. And I'm not the only one that thinks this. If you go over to Amazon, you'll find it currently with 83 reviews, averaging 4.5 stars. So a generally well-received little microphone. Now let's switch gears and look at the more premium Toner USB microphone kit. As I mentioned, it's not just the microphone, but it includes all of the basic added accessories that you will need to get the most out of your audio recordings. The kit contains a Q9 USB condenser microphone, an adjustable scissor arm, a pop filter, windscreen, shock mount, and a long 1.8 meter USB cable. The cable on the aforementioned budget microphone is maybe a little bit more than a meter for comparison. It is a noise canceling microphone that's captured via a 16 millimeter diaphragm. It does feature a cardioid pickup pattern, which simply means that the microphone's going to capture audio in one direction and not capture audio in all the encompassing directions. You can't adjust that. Some higher-end microphones will let you change the pickup pattern. This one only captures the audio that's directly in front of it. It does have a gain adjustment, which is nice to see. It more or less changes how sensitive the microphone is, if you want to think of it that way. If you hold the button either up or down, it will mute the microphone, not turn it off. It will stay connected to your PC, and you can simply mute it if you want to stop recording for a brief segment. And the indicator light will be on as long as the device is plugged in. The setup experience is obviously more complicated than the budget offering. That's just by virtue of having so many additional accessories to set up. This is definitely something you want in a more permanent recording situation. This is not something you want to pack up and take on the go. You'll start things off by attaching the scissor arm to the grip that can attach to desks of many various sizes, and then slide that windscreen over the top of the microphone. It attaches very easily. And then you can slide the microphone into the shock mount, which can be done by pinching either side of the shock mount, and it increases the inner diameter of the shock mount, allowing you to easily slide the microphone in. You'll then attach the shock mount to the scissor arm simply by screwing it on and making adjustments there. And finally, attach the pop filter anywhere on the arm where it's not going to impede the functionality and adjustment of the arm. This microphone, just like the budget one, is plug and play. No additional drivers needed. You'll be set up in just a matter of minutes. Although I do praise the microphone for having gain adjustment to begin with, I much prefer having a dial, because looking at these two buttons, I can't tell just how sensitive my microphone is right now. I have to make adjustments, record it, and listen back to it, and then make adjustments from there. As opposed to something like a Blue Yeti that has an actual dial on it, I can just look at it and see how sensitive my recording is going to be, and I may want to make adjustments depending on the scenario that I'm in. Also, the indicator light, I do like that you can mute the microphone, but the indicator light should shut off when it's muted and not just when it's unplugged. I don't really care if the light is on, if the microphone's plugged in. I want to know whether or not it's actually going to be recording me, so I prefer the light turn off when the microphone's muted. And just like the budget offering, the Toner microphone kit is very well received over on Amazon. It's only come out in the last couple of weeks, but it's already the number one new release in condenser microphones. For the comparison, I decided to put both these microphones at the same distance away, recording at the same exact time, just to give you the most direct comparison between the two. Now, what you're hearing is directly from the microphones. I did not edit the audio at all. I wanted to give you an exact interpretation of what you would hear if you were to use either of these two microphones. And you'll have to forgive the script, because I wanted to make sure I covered a lot of things in regards to the features and also the audio quality, so I don't want to forget anything. So starting things off, we'll take a look at the Toner Q9, and as you can hear, the audio quality is surprisingly good. I'd even venture to say it rivals the more expensive Blue Yeti, which is what I use for all of my videos so far. I can sit back with confidence and know that the microphone will still capture the audio clearly, and if I come up closer, I know the windscreen and the pop filter will help protect the audio from the adverse effects of vocal plosives, such as B's or P's or any unwanted wind that could max out the capabilities of the microphone. The shock mount reduces the vibration noise that comes from touching the surface the microphone is attached to, and finally, the adjustable arm provides great flexibility, so you can position the microphone exactly where you need it to get the best audio quality. Switching over to the budget mic, you can hear a noticeable drop in quality. The volume is reduced, the clarity is hindered, and there is more static present in the background. And despite those flaws, it still sounds great for a $15, $16 product. The best audio quality, however, is captured by getting as close as possible to the mic. Unfortunately, this can overload the microphone if you get too close or you're too loud. It comes with the windscreen, but can only protect the microphone so much. No shock mount means any and all contact with the desk is going to make an appearance in the audio recording. The neck is adjustable, but it gives a very limited range of motion, so you can't get as close as you would probably want to the source. It's advertised as an omnidirectional mic, but the best audio is captured when the mic is pointed directly at the source. At this point in the review, I typically conclude my thoughts and tell you whether or not I think a product is worth buying. Well, I hope you're not surprised to find that I'm not going to recommend outright one of these products over the other. They're for more or less different use cases. They have different price points and different accessories. The point of this video is to show you what you can get for a budget-friendly option and what you can get for spending a little bit more and getting all the added accessories that typically go with getting the most out of an audio recording. If what you hear in the budget microphone is sufficient for your recording needs and you need to do this recording on the go primarily, then I would stick with this option and save yourself a little bit of money. If you have more of a stationary recording setup and you like more of the audio quality from this one and you feel that you're going to be doing this more and more frequently, recording sound for videos, then I would recommend spending a little bit more money and getting the more expensive one. If you didn't like the feature set or the audio quality of the microphones we featured today, please consider watching our other reviews where we may offer something that you might enjoy more. And again, if you want to purchase any of these items we've reviewed in this video, please consider using our affiliate links. And also check that description for contest giveaways that we do somewhat regularly. And also make sure you subscribe so you know when our newest content is ready to watch. Thanks for watching, and we'll catch you guys next time.